I think running a little bit more, but that's my game style. It didn't bother me that much. But yeah, you could feel that the level of tennis dropped a little bit in the third set. But I don't think not dramatically.
Was it? You got the service break right away in the third set after it seemed like the momentum was on his side. Did you feel at that point like you got a chance to?
I'm overall not happy with my service. Okay. I'm serving way better than I'm serving all this week. But I'm happy the way I play my ground strokes, which are my biggest weapon. But the serve is just not. It's just on and off. You know, I have a few games I'm serving really well, winning at least 2 points equal, I want to say easy on my first serve, and then just suddenly I have no help from the serve, and I have to, you know, grind and build up every single point, and that's really a disadvantage in a tight match like this when you have to serve to stay in a set or a match, or when you play against a big server like that.
Now they talk about tall tennis, about a lot of tall players in the game now. Sam Isner, Berdych, Del Potro, and so forth. What do you think of that trend, and how do you break that down?
The thing is that, I mean, I heard a lot of talk about tall players, but I wouldn't say taking over. There's a few of them, you know, out there, but obviously the huge advantage is the serve, and which surprises me, they play much better on slower surfaces, slower hard court, or even play sometimes, because you know, the serve is fast, and then I mean it's fast on clay, grass, or wherever. You know, it's just that it's much easier for them to move. And I think their fitness coaches did a good job by, I don't want to say teaching them how to move on a tennis court, but using the height that they in 2 or 3 steps they're already on the ball. Obviously, all of them need to play a very aggressive kind of tennis. They cannot run or grind too much. But the serve is a huge advantage, and also the reach on the return, which is, in my experience, very annoying when I play, let's say, Marin Cilic, which I have a very negative score.
So do you think that will be a decisive, I mean, still Fed, Nadal, Novak are not really, are not that tall. Do you think that will be the trend of the future or not?
Well, it's certainly going to be a boost for, you know, taller guys to continue playing tennis. You know, some of them, they just, when they're tall, they think I'm bored to play basketball or whatever. Definitely, you know, if you know how to work on your physique, it doesn't really matter. I mean, tennis is one of the sports where it supports all builds of a human body, whether you are like not so tall, like, I don't know, or pro tools or whatever, or if you are really, really tall. I mean, if you adjust your game, there are enough tournaments over the year, all different sorts of surfaces, different balls, so you know, if you're good, you're going to be at the top, whether you are small or big.
Are there many players outside of Sam who are so obviously you can tell when they're upset with themselves that they get really down on the court?
I know how Sam is upset. I don't know what the side
is. His body language sometimes.
You know, I didn't see him upset. I saw him really tired. You know, the thing is that, you know, the way that he was moving and also the speed of his serve decreased. But I never saw Sam like really upset, apart from maybe 1 or 2 times discussing was it a left with the referee, you know? But I never see Sam breaking records, so, you know, it's just, I guess that's the way he is.
Any more questions?
Nanko, you mentioned that Sam looked tired. A lot of the players have been talking about the conditions and the heat. Can you comment on that, how that affected your play?
I'm coming from Atlanta last week where it was a disaster, like weather-wise, you know. But I felt tired, but not because of the weather. So that we played 2.5 to 45, and I had a much easier match than Sam yesterday. He played, I don't know, 7-6 in the third. So it's normal to feel tired, you know. I mean, I'll credit for him because he managed to get out of 2 matches, which in my opinion he should have lost. But you know, as I said, he has a wind in his back, so he can just when it's important, he's coming up with big shots.
You're a good run in Holland to the final, but also some tough losses this year. How would you view, you know, when you step back a week or two from now, your run here in Los Angeles?
I don't want to say happy with the semifinal. I was playing good. I'm disappointed the way that it ended. It's not a bad thing or a disgrace to lose to Sam Curry, which is one of the top guys, you know, on hard courts. But just the way I lost with all the chances and the opportunities to make the finals here is a little bit disappointing. You know, I'll take probably a day off tomorrow and hope that this doesn't affect me mentally.
And how, I mean, Sam's moving forward, top 20 range. How far do you think he can go? Do you think he can...
He has a top 10 potential for sure. I'm not sure if he has it this year. But, you know, in order to be... He's a steady top 20 player, you know, but in order to be top 10, you need to perform good on Grand Slams and Master Series. I don't know his results on Wimbledon or Australian Open.
First round.
This makes the difference, you know. Winning a 250 event helps, but I mean, winning a Master Series event with 1,000 points is like winning four of these, like lower tournaments. So in order to be top 10, you need play big on a big stage.
Last question in English? No? You
want to
go ahead and
tell me? Okay.
Test completed.